I study the ways in which big data can be used to improve children's health around the world. As a researcher and as a mother, it's my job to help other families create healthy children. When we study children's health, we need to be mindful and try to incorporate and understand data, not just where they were and what infectious agent they might have been exposed to, but what other children they came into contact with and how their nutrition might also affect their immune function or their age or how many children are in their household. This creates this massive amount of data that we need to sort through in order to understand children's health. We can't understand children's health unless we look at it in this very multifactorial, ecological way. I've been on several projects that have been studying how effective vaccines are in different countries around the world. Medical trials that are the gold standard in medical research have challenges understanding exactly how a medical intervention is working. My research is taking the data and linking in information about the children and their families and the environments that they live in and create statistical analyses that better examine how the vaccine is working. And indeed, much of the research that we've done has found that the vaccine actually works better than the investigators thought because we were incorporating the complexities of the world that sort of mess up the way a vaccine trial is supposed to work in the field. I have studied all of the different socioeconomic factors that exist in their neighborhoods and their families that may influence how well children perform at reading and math, vaccines and birth defects, infant mortality, and low birth weight. There are so many topics that we can use large data sets that are out there waiting for us. We have to have researchers who understand how to use these data to examine these problems in depth with all the complication that's around them. This is what big data can do.